The Orionids Meteor Shower is an annual meteor shower that occurs in late October, and it is associated with Halley's Comet. It is caused by the Earth passing through the debris left behind as it makes its journey around the Sun. When a comet swings by the Sun, it leaves a long trail of dust and debris in its wake. And when the Earth passes and intersects this trail of dust left behind, the particles burn up in our atmosphere, creating a days-long or weeks-long spectacular celestial display. In this video, we will examine the pathway of Halley's Comet, details about the Orionids, and tips and tricks you can use to help you make the most of viewing this shower. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and I'll be your guide as we explore the night sky one constellation at a time. The Earth passes through the debris left by Halley's Comet twice each year, leading to two annual meteor showers. The first encounter is in early May and is called the Eta Aquarids Meteor Shower. It typically peaks around May 5th or 6th, but starts in late April. The Orionids mark the second encounter, and that occurs in late October into November, but it usually peaks between October 20th to October 22nd each year. All meteor showers are a result of tiny fragments of either a comet or an asteroid that left behind dust and debris. And when this enters the Earth's atmosphere, it creates these streaks of light because this dust is burning up in the atmosphere due to the intense friction that's happening. The Orionids are typically active from early October into early November, but their peak activity occurs around October 20th to the 22nd each year. And the radiant point for this meteor shower comes from the constellation Orion, and it's near the bright star of Betelgeuse. This radiant point is caused by the effect of perspective, which is very similar to parallel railroad tracks that are converging at a single vanishing point along the horizon when you view it from the middle of the tracks. The particles in a meteor shower are all traveling in parallel paths and at the same velocity, so they all will peer to an observer who is photographing them to radiate from a single point. And meteor showers are almost always named after the constellation from which they appear to originate from. So if you look at this photograph, it's a 4-hour time lapse of a meteor shower. And if you trace all these points back to the original point, that is where the radiant would be. And remember, when you're viewing meteor showers, you're not going to notice this radiant effect. It's really only when you're photographing them. If you're just outside looking at the meteor shower, you're just going to see random streaks of light that randomly appear in the sky. And it happens so quickly, like in a fraction of a second. You can almost blink and miss a meteor. The Orionids are visible from both the northern and southern hemispheres. The shower is more active in the hours before the dawn, so it's best viewed in the early morning hours when the constellation of Orion is high in the sky. In 2023, when this video is being recorded, the moon will be in a waxing phase, which means that it'll be out in the early evening and absent during the early morning hours, which is the best time to view the meteors. During the peak of the Orionids, it can produce an average of 20 to 25 meters per hour. But ultimately, what you see in the night sky is dependent on many factors, such as the amount of light pollution in your local area. Usually, the biggest challenge with all celestial events is having cooperative weather and clear skies. The constellation of Orion is one of the easiest ones to find in the night sky. If you take a look at this photo, you can probably easily point out the pattern that you can see in the night sky. And all seven of the main stars are of relatively similar brightness. If you look at this stellar map here, you can see that Betelgeuse is here, Bellatrix, Rigel, Safe, and then the belt stars right here. And the radiant for this meteor shower is right in this area above Betelgeuse. I've got a few more photos to share with you just so you can learn how to find Orion. Hopefully you can see it on the left side of the photo right here. You can use the belt stars to help aim you towards Taurus. And then here, of course, are the Pleiades. Here are a few other photos. Are you able to see Orion on the right side of your screen? Hopefully you can, because this is one of the most important constellations for you to know, because it acts as a celestial guide. You can use it to point to all the other major constellations in the area. So I hope this was helpful in helping you recognize what Orion looks like. I do have more detailed videos about this constellation, especially since it's such an easy one to find and it's so popular. So I'll put the link to those videos in the description below. If you want to learn more about Halley's Comet, I recommend you go to the website known as Eyes on the Solar System. This is a real-time simulation about what's going on in our own solar system, and it's so easy to manipulate and lots of fun to explore. I use it in my classroom all the time. And if you click up here on the menu and you come here to Halley's Comet, it will take you exact to the spot where Halley's Comet is in its orbit, what its shape is like, and it's very easy to manipulate. So here is where Halley is right now in its orbit. So I couldn't help myself. I wanted to learn more about this comet. I mean, of course, most people do know about this comet, but the last time it was visiting us, I wasn't even in double digits in my age yet. So I'm going to be about 80 years old the next time Halley's comes around in 2061, I believe it is. So you can click here and then it'll take you. You can do some cool size comparisons as well. You know, here's Halley's Comet compared to some other objects throughout the solar system. And I just find it really fascinating that we even have this data available to us and that we are able to explore the solar system in this fashion. Thank you so much for watching this video about the Orionids meteor shower. Let me know in the comments below, have you been able to see any meteors so far from your part of the world? This meteor shower does go until early November, so hopefully you can catch a few throughout the next couple weeks. Remember, it takes time, patience, and practice to learn about the sky and how it changes throughout the year. As always, I wish you clear skies and keep looking up.